I like what they're doing. They're doing all this stuff, but they get way too much attention for it.
Yeah.
Like, everyone's paying attention to them, and we can't. And basically, we're just lone wolves now.
Well, I think it's pretty cool, though, that the 6-year-old little girls are dropping in bowls and stuff.
I never thought it was a girl-boy thing. I mean, the Pink Helmet Posse thing kind of came up by accident, I guess.
It was a total accident.
We were just kind of laughing at them because they all were tooling around the skate park just, you know, with their little pink helmets on. I don't know. I'm inspired, you know. I think she's put a lot of work into it, and she doesn't realize how much work she's put into it.
It can definitely help in the future, you know, influence girls to start skating at a young age.
I am 6. I like to skate. I think that's all.
I don't want to say she's a tomboy by any means, but
she's definitely not frilly.
Not a girly girl. She doesn't really wear that many dresses and stuff like that. You know, I don't know if that's ever really fit into her lifestyle that much.
My favorite princess is Cinderella. Because I like her dress. I want to be a professional skateboarder one day. Sometimes I like to wear a tutu. Sometimes I like to wear pants. I wish there was more girls at the skate park because I wanted to be in the same amount of girls to be skating as the same amount of boys.
The whole goal is to get other girls to go and try it out and have fun and give them a forum, a place to go, a place that feels like a community of other girls that are their age, that are like-minded, that just like to go skateboard. There shouldn't be a set way you're supposed to act, you know? So if you're a kid, have fun, do fun things.
I like that, says Pink Helmet Posse.
The mini boards that were there were more directed towards boys, as they would be, and they like fairies and rainbows and stuff like that. Like, you know what I mean? So we said, hey, let's find we found one of the best guys that builds boards. We made some sizes. We painted them pink and purple because they like pink and purple. And, you know, they're the right size for small girls to go skateboarding.
What the heck? This one's horrible. I'm not going to show them. Fine, you can have a quick peek. See, I said you can have a quick peek.
Yeah, Bella has definitely gained an amazing amount of confidence from surfing and skating. She is super shy. I mean, even people she knows that she'll be around, she'll get shy and clam up, but if she's skateboarding or surfing, she comes alive.
I started skateboarding when I was 5. I want to get really good at skating because I want to go to X Games. I pretty much always go last or second. Rella snakes me too.
You know, she kind of does her own thing usually.
They're gonna be the first generation of 8 and 9-year-old girl rippers.
She will try hard, harder than most of the boys I see.
They do not want to feel the pain.
You're okay, Rouse. Come here. You're alright.
Sometimes I just slide on my knees. Sometimes I get burns. Sometimes I hurt my knees. Sometimes I get bruises from the shin. I don't know, like that. Sometimes I fall on my pad. Sometimes I fall on my hip. Sometimes I fall on my bone. I want to start skateboarding again. Lest I fall.
Her whole life she's going to have to prove to the boys that she can do it. And it may not even be a problem. I mean, it might just be something she's used to doing, and she'll just continuously have to prove herself.
it's changing, and there's no stopping it, you know. And I think with that change, there'll be a lot more female skating.
What I'm learning is there's no limits to what they can do. Like, I certain times think there's no way they can do that. There's no way she can do this. And she'll do it. And I'll be like, I'm just going to keep my mouth shut. Like, what do I know, you know?
Like crazy pro chicks.
Yeah, crazy pro chicks.